Hello there, my dear friends. This is the Armenian King, and today I'm going to show you some Rome Total War tournament battles. This is the second round. I was tied with GOTW Lampin or Lampin, I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. The rules were we should play as Egypt and Britain, then switch factions. And if the one of the players wins both battles 2-0, he advances to the next round. But if it's draw, the players must play as long as one of the players one of them gets 2 advantage of 2, like 3-1, 2-4, and 5-3 and act. In the first battle, I was playing as Egypt and Lampin was playing as Britain. Yeah, let's take a look at the builds. Let's first take a look at the Lampin's builds. He has got 6 slingers, of course, gold, 4 silver swordsmen, and 2 gold British head harlers. And of course, some British warlords with 1 upgrade. And who are these guys? Oh, and 2 British heavy chariots. Oh, just look at this. My archers managed to destroy one of these slingers. Yeah, and now let's take a look at my army. I've got 2 chariot archers, 4 units of this Nile infantry. Just look at this, they are going to be destroyed. Yeah, these swordsmen chase them, swordsmen can actually destroy them, but I have some Pharaoh's Guard, and my Pharaoh's Guard can actually beat these chosen swordsmen. If they are, of course, used properly. Yeah, one of my Nile infantry units is wrecked already. I have turned off how it's called, skirmish mode. Yeah, skirmish mode, so my archers will stand and try to kill the chariots with their arrows, but I messed it up a bit, not a bit, very much, I would say, and lost a lot of Nile infantry units and a lot of archers. I have got no chariots here, no heavy chariots, just 2. Where are they? They are already dead. Just 2 chariot archers, so this is a very tough situation for me. He has got head harlers, he has got a lot of slingers, he has got chariots, and he has got swordsmen. What I've got, just pikemen, archers, and worse pikemen, who can only kill chariots and can do nothing against these swordsmen. Yeah, my elite archers are being wrecked by this chariot. Let's see. I rush with my pikeman, turn on phalanx formation, and he brings his chariots. I just hope he would lose his generally at some point, and I will get the advantage when the Britons lose their general. Their morale drops very, very fast, and then it's very easy to beat them, especially when you shot these head harlers and slingers with flaming arrows. They just break and rout and flee from the field. Yeah, This battle is over, I can do nothing here. Yeah, very well played by my opponent, and very poorly played by me. It's mostly because of my build. I just wanted to try it. It used to work for me when I played Rome Total War well. I would not say that I play it well now. Okay, let's go to the next battle. Okay, this is the second battle between me and Lampin, and I rush with my chariot archers, and I'm going to lose them, I guess. Yeah, very very poor start for me, but I can fix it. I can just kill all of these chariots and get the advantage. Yeah, now I get the advantage. Actually, he lost two of his chariots, I lost only one chariot archer. So yeah, chariots are probably more very valuable in this battle, I mean heavy chariots, than chariot archers. Yeah, now I have concentrated fire on this pharaoh guard. Let's take a look. They lose no one, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, this looks very very much into my favor, I guess. But the advantage is not huge, so yeah. He has still got infantry, he has still got archers who are actually better than my slingers. Why they are better? Because of their longer range, of course. But I don't get why no pharaoh's archers. I think they are they give Egypt a huge advantage, because they have even longer range than these archers, and they can just wreck slingers, head harlers from long range. Okay, now we go for these chariots. I have turned on guard mode, so I can escape from this battle in every moment I like. Yeah, that's why I like guard mode with chariots. Oh shit, just look at this. I am going to lose this one unit, I guess. Just let's take a look. No, yeah, that's it. He goes for my swordsman, and I use my head harlers to destroy these chariots, and head harlers actually destroy chariots very well. Now I get even more advantage, I guess, because he has got only one unit of chariots. That's huge, I guess. If I catch this one chariot, it's probably going to be easy for me. Just look at this. He breaks some of my units with his chariots, I hope that these head harlers could beat these chariots, but they couldn't do it. Okay, he goes for my other units of head harlers, but he doesn't want to send his chariots too far away from his main army, from his pharaoh's guard, because I will destroy these chariots if they are unprotected, if they are not protected by infantry. Okay, now I will just avoid skirmishing with my slingers, and we'll try to kill as many archers as possible with my chariot archers. Let's triple. It can take a while. Yeah, that's it. He wants to get these guys. I retreat with them. Then he wants to get these guys. Then I retreat with those guys. So I can use my chariot archers. effectively. Now I bring my slingers and three chariots, so my army won't be too separated. Now he goes for these guys. Now I retreat with them and come from the rear with these guys. That's it. This means that I have got this situation. Situation is under my control because I've actually surrounded my opponent. It's not fully, and he is not fully surrounded, but from two sides is not bad. It's half surrounded, semi surrounded situation. Okay, let's triple. Are my chariot archers actually shouting or not? Yeah, they are. And they are shouting this unit of Pharaoh Guard. Yeah. Pharaoh Guard unit is easy to kill for archers because they have no shields. And yeah, maybe they have not bad armor, but they have no shields, so they are very, very vulnerable to missile attacks. So yeah, we will wait. He has some chariot unit hidden somewhere. I don't know where, but he has, because I didn't kill the last unit of chariots. Oh, here it is. He was hiding his unit somewhere here. But I don't think these two chariots can kill all of these chariot archers, because my chariot archers are actually gold. Yeah, that's it. We have killed the last chariot. And now our advantage is even bigger. I guess it's too close, he can kill some of my chariots. Yeah, mistake by me. Now it's time for real skirmishing. Slingers against archers. Yeah, I want to kill these archers very quickly. But then go for this Pharaoh Guard. But he wants to push my slingers back, and so his archers will get some free kills. Oh shit, just look at this. I just wasted two of my chariots, and my advantage can go away if I go on like this. The thing is, my slingers are in loose formation, his archers are not in loose formation, so that gives me advantage in skirmishing. So I guess I must win the skirmish fight. And just look, these archers are pretty much beat up, and 16, 14, 15, and my guys are 33, 34, 29. Yeah, here we go. My head hurlers come, but head hurlers are actually good in melee. Of course, if they are not fighting against a unit like Praetorian Guard, and I don't know, Spartan Hoplites, they do well. Yeah, this is it. 1-1, and we must play again. In the next battle, I will play as Egypt again, and Lampin will play as Britons. Okay, let's go to the next battle. And yeah, this time I have changed my army. I've got a lot of chariots, but they are not very well upgraded. Only two upgrades in each. I've got two chariot archers, gold attack, and yeah, six Pharaoh's guard. My general is gold. Rest are only gold defense because Britons are actually skirmish factions, so it's better to upgrade defense than attack. If you don't have enough money, of course, if you have enough money, just upgrade both, because Britons will probably have swordsmen, and you need some attack power to beat the swordsmen. I've got two units of elite archers, gold attack, and four units of regular archers, gold. I didn't really need 8 archers, but I really need long range archers. Okay, that's it. I just push these slingers back with my spearmen, and here we go. I just try to kill everyone with these chariots, then pull back, then turn on phalanx, and try to kill all of these chariots with my phalanx. Guard mode is on. Yeah, that's it. Now it's time to pull back. Now it's time to pull back, and let's see how many of these chariots will die. That's it. My archer stand and shot. Oh, we have the quantity advantage here, and we killed Britain general. Now it's time to turn on flaming arrows. Oh, one of my Pharaoh's guard is gets wrecked. Yeah, but that doesn't matter. If we kill these chariots, the battle is over. Let's see. My archers stand and shot, and now they can actually rout these chariots because their general has recently died, so their morale is awful now. Just look at this. My Pharaoh guard has caught one of his chariot units, and now I can actually beat these chariots. Yeah, and I have surrounded this sword, must choose a sword, with my Pharaoh's guard. Yeah, that's it. We are going to win the chariot fight because of the better morale. Yeah, that's it. This battle is over. After losing his general, Lampis, after losing general, British army just routed. Yeah, that's it. 2-1 for me, and we are going to the fourth battle, in which I will play as Britons and Lampin will play as Egypt. And yeah, this is the fourth battle, and I've got pretty much the same army as in the second battle. 4-6 British warlords. Only general is upgraded. General is I guess silver defense. Rest are not upgraded because they can beat fully upgraded Egyptian chariots even without any upgrades. Yeah, my chariot archers are gold. Why I make them gold in this battle? Because firstly, Britons are very cheap, so there are always some extra money left. Secondly, they will be killed harder by these archers. It will be harder for these archers to kill them. And thirdly, is there a word like that? Thirdly, or I don't know. Okay. And of course, for making them stronger in melee. When they go out of ammunition, they can be pretty solid chariots with gold defense and gold attack. Okay, let's triple because we are going to see a lot of skirmishing and this battle is very, very long. Oh, wait. We are going to miss this. He has changed his army and he has got these desert cavalry. Yeah. I sent my chariots for them. They are very, very fast and they can actually easily outrun my chariots. And what else he has got? A lot of gold. 6 units of gold Pharaoh's Guard, 6 units of gold regular archers, and a lot of chariots. Oh, 4 units of chariots, okay. Of course, this desert cavalry is useful, but I guess not against Britons. They can actually be useful against Britons, but they are not worth bringing. You must have more chariots against Britons, or you can go full infantry like I did in the first battle when I failed and bring a couple of these desert cavalry. Yeah, now my opponent tries to rush. Very good idea. He does what I did in the previous battle, just rushing my army, and I lost one of my chariots, and it's time to pull back. Yeah, and he wants to attack my army through his spy, through his Pharaoh guards. Then if I attack his chariots with my chariots, he will just turn on the phalanx, and I will lose all of my chariots. Now just look at this, he gets some free kills, he just kills my gold, silver swordsman. That sucks. Yeah, I bring my headhunters, a very bad start for me. Yeah, but actually I've killed one of his desert cavalry, I guess, or not. Yeah, but it came back from routing, so yeah. My opponent has the advantage right now. I turned off skirmish mode so my head harlots could stand and throw some heads on these chariots, but they actually broke very quickly and I lost them, I guess. Yeah, now it's time to catch this desert cavalry. I need to get rid of his cavalry, his chariot, his desert cav. Then it will be possible for me to win. But even if I destroy all of his chariots and light cav, I'm not sure if I will have advantage after that. Okay, now my chariots are chasing this desert cav. There is a lot of micro going on the battlefield. Yeah, very smart play from my opponent. Yeah, I'm going to lose my swordsman here. Very, very well played by Lampin. This one annoying desert calf makes me under pressure all the time, but I have caught it. I have caught the unit. Okay. My chariots are out. Damn. He has got a desert calf unit here, and he finally remembered about it. when we take a look at my opponent's army, we can see that he has still got a considerable number of chariots. I must get rid of them somehow. But I am confident at this point because I have two chariot archers. And if I kill my opponent's chariots, I can use my chariot archers very effectively. I can just harass my opponent's chariots with these horse archers, then kill them, all of them, or make them waste ammunition on my chariot archers. Then I will use my slingers in great for great effect. But firstly we need to get rid of these heavy chariots of Egypt. Wait. Yeah. Again, very beautifully played by Lampin. He keeps his chariots with his Pharaoh's guard, so I can't kill them easily. When I try to kill them, he will just pull back and send his Pharaoh's guard forward and turn on phalanx mode, and I will just lose my chariots easily. The only thing I can do here, just pull back and try to kill as many archers as possible with my chariot archers. Let's triple it. Let's turn on triple speed. Yeah, that's it. We go for these chariots. Now I must pull out. Or otherwise I'm going to lose a lot of chariots. Just look at this. Oh, actually we managed to kill some of his chariots, but Egyptian archers routed two of my chariots, so I'm not sure if this was worth it. What else we have got besides these slingers? Some headhunters. Yeah, two units and two units of beaten up swordsmen. Yeah. Here we go. We actually kept these Egyptians busy while our slingers just retreated. So it was worth it, I guess, because we could actually lose our slingers. They were pretty close and it was already very hard to pull back with them. Okay, now let's triple. Oh, wait. He goes for my chariots and I'm not sure if he can kill. Yeah, that's it. Only three units of chariots left. And those are very small units. 9, 9, 6. Yeah. It's time to harass archers. But I guess we can actually rest a bit first, then try to kill archers with our chariot archers, because our chariot archers are exhausted and archers actually can kill them. Yeah, even the fact that their defense is gold will not save them. So yeah, I should have suggested my opponent to make it fast forward and let our units rest. My opponent gets that he just can't chase all of these slingers and chariots, and he just stands and tries defensive tactics. Good idea. The more he chases, the easier I can surround him. So that's it. These guys are actually out of ammunition, but they make Egyptians to waste ammunition on them. Yeah. I always keep them going around like this. I always keep them in counterbalance circle, but they go out of ammunition, so opponent thinks that they still have got some ammunition and waste a lot of ammo on them. Now I can just pause and we can go on the battle after our units are fresh. Now they are exhausted. Okay, now my units are fresh. It's time to use my fresh chariot archers. He concentrates fire with all of his archers on this one unit of chariots, but they are fresh. It's not going to be easy to kill them. He advances. Yeah, now he just prepares himself for my attack, because I'm going to attack soon, because these chariot archers are only two and it's not going to be very very hard to kill them. Let's see. Yeah, I go for skirmishing. I turned off skirmish mode. My slinger just stand. They don't retreat. I don't need them to retreat. Yeah, now I will catch my opponent's chariots and I will try to kill his general. Or I've already killed this general, I don't remember, no. Now Egyptian general is dead. Okay, let's see, skirmishing still goes on. And let's see if we have got the advantage. Yeah, actually we have the advantage. And now I will get even more advantage, and because I just surround my opponent with my slingers. You know, I didn't order my slingers to shot his archers. I left them in I left them to shot whoever they want, and they actually kill both these archers and Pharaoh's guard. That's it, my swordsman caught these archers. Now I have got a huge advantage, though my swordsman get wrecked by this Pharaoh's guard, but that doesn't matter, because only on my slingers without anyone's help can win this army. I've still got some head hurlers who can at least destroy one unit, because they probably have full ammunition or ammunition. Yeah, ammunition is more correct. That's it. 12, 32, 10. Yeah, this battle is pretty much over. Lumping admits defeat. Yeah, that's it. I advance to the third battle. In the first round, I advanced to the third round. I got default victory in the first round because my opponent was inactive. I couldn't find him. He was always offline. Then I go to the second round, met Lampin. Then I will meet Nord in the third battle. I will show you the replays of that match. So that's it. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe, and see you later.